you said, you complain way too much. And so John said, that's my New Year's resolution. My New Year's resolution is next year, I'm not going to make any complaint whatsoever. No complaining from me. You will hear no complaints whatsoever that comes out of my lips. December 31st. Due to some alcohol in the system, and it being late after midnight, John proceeds to complain how tired he was. He says, I don't know why we just don't celebrate New Year's at 10 o'clock or 9 o'clock at night instead of midnight. This is horrible. And his wife looks at him and says, I thought you said you were not going to complain anymore this year. It was then that John said, starting now. I will complain no more starting now. John started to get ready for bed. And he was out too fast. I can't believe that you have not gone to the store and got toothpaste for me. And his wife gave him that look. And John, all he could say was, starting now. It was in the morning. John had woken up. He had a good night's sleep. And he looked outside because he had things to do outside. And it was pouring down rain. And then all he could say was, I can't believe it's raining. All the days on my day off, I could have this long holiday. I could do things. And he complained and complained and complained. And his wife gave him that look one more time. And he said, starting now. For lunch, his wife fixed him black-eyed peas, and John did not like black-eyed peas. And you can imagine what John did. He complained the entire time at the dinner table about what he was eating. And his wife stood up, stomped her foot, and said, John, just shut up. If you want to stop complaining, don't say anything else the rest of the year. John can only say, starting now. That's oftentimes how we deal with things in our life. We want to better ourselves. We want to stop doing something, but we have such a habit of doing it. We have good intention of stopping doing those things, but we keep on doing them. And just like John, we oftentimes say, starting now. We'll start all over, starting now. It really shows how chaotic and how messy our lives really are with sin. We may try to better ourselves, but in so doing, we actually make life worse for those around us. Chaos. That's one way we can describe our lives. The sin that entangles us into, all the deception, all the lies that we live chaos. Chaotic lives, filled with sin, sin which leads to misery, misery which leads to death. It's quite interesting in our text this morning how God deals with chaos. Genesis chapter 1, verse 2. Oftentimes we overlook these words, but the text says, now it was formless and void. It's interesting because the two Hebrew words that are used there actually sound really, really kind of neat. The way they sound is tohu wabohu. Aren't those great words? Tohu wabohu. They sound wonderful. But the meaning is a formless void. Yes, chaos. And what does God do? God says, let there be light. And there was light. And God saw the light was good, and there was light, and there was darkness. And he separated between the light and the darkness. He called the light day, and the darkness he called night. And there was evening, and there was morning, the first day. How does God deal with chaos, but he organizes it? He does away with the chaos. He organizes it. What about our chaos? Our sin, our destruction, our misery, our death. It was on the Jordan River. Jesus came and was baptized. baptism because he knew no sin. But in his baptism, he was anointed for the ministry for you and for me. He was anointed to bear our sins, to bring organization, to bring order to our chaos, to bring forgiveness to our sinfulness. It is Jesus who was baptized, who lived for us, who died for us upon that cross to take away our sins, who rose again to give us everlasting life. It is in his death and in his resurrection that we have our beginnings. For we have been baptized into Christ's death and into his resurrection. We have been connected with Christ. We are connected with Jesus, and there is no separation. He has taken away our chaos, and he has given us organization. He has taken away the messiness of our sin, and he has given us everlasting life. Yes, God forgives us. That's how God deals with chaos. That's how God deals with our sinfulness, with our mess, and our messy lives. He is the one that cleans us up. He is the one who sent his son Jesus to take away all the stuff that makes chaotic lives, that makes sin, that causes us to have misery and then death. If you think about it, everything in this world that is outside of God ends in death, ends in a mess, ends in chaos. But with God, there is life. For God who spoke, let there be light, is the same God who spoke. This is my beloved Son. With him, I am well pleased. And it is through his death and his resurrection that God also speaks to you and to me. And God says, you are my dear child. With you, I am well pleased. Yes, chaos. Organization from sin to forgiveness, from death to life. That is how our God deals not only with the world in his creating voice, but in his forgiving and loving voice, he also deals with us and gives us everlasting life. Paul and Lillian were on their way home from a family trip, visiting family for Christmas. And they were getting low on gas, and so Paul pulled into a gas station, and Lil, she was sitting in the passenger seat, intensely reading a book, with no inkling idea what's going on around her. Paul opened the car door to get gas, and when his foot hit the pavement and closed the door, and his other foot hit the same pavement, he slipped and fell. Where there was a sheet of ice that could be undetainable, unnoticeable from the car. He laid there in pain, in agony, and Lil kept reading her book, not understanding what's going on. But Paul was hurting. Any movement he made was not a movement upward because it was so slick. He finally managed to grab the tire, the front tire, the driver's side tire, and he got up to his feet. And it took him about 5 minutes. And he slowly walked around the car to the gas pump. It was then that Lil looked up and noticed there was no gas being pumped. So Lil rolled down her window and started chewing on Paul. What are you doing? It's taking you this long to even get the gas pumps going? And Paul couldn't say a word. For Paul, his life was chaotic at that time. How could he explain that he slipped on the ice? So we also, many times in our lives, fall for good reason. And many times it's because of our sinfulness, because of our lies, our deception, the webs we weave. But it is God who brings us up. It is God who brings order, who brings life. Us and gives us